All right, it's roundtable time where we bring the forums to life right here on American Airgunner. Today I got a pretty solid group here. We're going to obviously be talking about something hunting because I got the American Airgun Hunter, Mr. Jim Chapman, the Urban Airgunner, Rick Ward, and of course the Godfather, Tom Gaylord. All right, guys, today we are talking predators, but a little bit different. I want to know specifically when it comes to a predator gun, what are you looking for? I'm going to start here.
Okay.
For the people out there that don't know, what's a predator?
Well, in the United States, predator usually falls into fox, coyote, bobcat. Depends on where you go, though. I include raccoons in that because if you're out calling, the most aggressive animal to a call sometimes, surprisingly, is a raccoon.
Really?
Yeah, they'll come in a distress call and they'll climb right up your leg almost. And okay. In some places, it's also a mountain lion. Mm-hmm. And some people consider bear. I consider more of a game animal.
And these are the type of animals, though, that attack cattle, eat dogs and cats. I mean, these are like they're predators. They're on the prowl hunting things.
Sure.
Can you eat predators?
Some places do eat predators. It depends. I mean, you know, down in Louisiana, I mean, you can eat coon. I mean, coon is actually very, very good if it's cooked right. I mean, you can have it gravy or whatever.
Is it not surprising that you've eaten raccoons?
Well, you know, you really. When you hunt like I do and people say, well, you got to eat what you kill, sometimes you want to try it.
For the most part, we're talking about where it's some sort of pest control, it's protection,
right.
it's some, so you're protecting something. There's a reason you're hunting these animals.
And also fur bears. I mean, they take coyote pelts, bobcat pelts, right. And for fur is another reason.
So what are you looking for in a gun if you're going to go out and hunt these suckers?
Well, Jim, go ahead.
I was going to let you do it.
Are you sure?
Yeah, all right, Tom,
all
go
right,
ahead.
Go to me.
Yeah, come on.
Because I ain't got much to say.
That's a lie.
But I do hunt coyotes a little bit.
Okay.
And the one thing I've discovered is, unlike deer hunting, you need a gun you can maneuver very stealthily and quietly with a predator. Because they're very alert. Not the deer aren't alert, but predators are really alert.
Are you moving around? Are you in a blind? Are you on the trek? What's the...
Most of the time, it's a spot and stalk type deal. You'll find a place where you think the coyotes are moving, and you typically want to set up, 45, 50 yards off of that trail.
Mm-hmm.
And where the coyote generally comes in is where you least expect it.
All right, so this is all good info, but I want to get back to, like, what are we looking for in the gun specific?
The gun I'm using mostly right now for the Midwestern type of hunting is the Evenex Sniper, and I've got it both in the rifle and the carbine. And okay. I like that gun. I'm shooting in .357. It's putting out about 120 foot-pound of energy, shooting Diablo pellets. Mm-hmm. And I like the Diablos because they don't carry too far. You know, lead cast bullet, my other gun that I'm using shoots lead cast bullets in .357. Same caliber, completely different gun.
Right.
And I like that because the range, outside of 100, 150 yards, the pellet's gone. It's already dropped. So I've got something I'm going to use in for that 50, 60-yard shot.
As far as a gun goes, I use a smaller caliber. I like to use a 25 caliber.
Mm-hmm.
I like to use one that has a shrouded barrel.
Right.
It's extremely quiet, and it can deliver up to about 85 foot-pounds of
okay.
energy. And I use the Diablo pellet, but I've recently switched to a heavier grain pellet, so I've kind of shortened in my distance. I'm using like a 33, 34 grain.
And that's enough to take down a coyote?
Absolutely.
Yeah, are you talking headshots?
You're sticking with headshots.
I'm sticking with headshots. Let's make that clear.
Headshots only.
Yeah. Because in an urban area, you don't want... Number one, you do not want a coyote to expire in somebody's front yard. We try to anchor the coyote right where he's standing. And so, yes, a headshot, and there's nothing wrong with a headshot. Coyotes are very resilient animals. I've seen them run long distance with a .223 going straight through them. You know, we use multiple guns.
Rick, you would probably agree. Having a compact gun, and you already said it, Tom, having a compact gun that you can move around with real easy. And I like either short carbines like the Sniper, or I like a bullpup.
Yeah.
Like the Slayer.
Godfather, when was the first coyote ever taken?
When was the first?
Yeah.
Oscar Leibowitz took him in 1417. He was shooting a Turkish crossbow that had a cast range of, I think it was 800 yards.
Nice.
Unbelievable.
Unbelievable stuff.
I thought it was probably 6,000 miles to reach from Turkey over to the States for the coyote.
So there you go. That's it for this round table, guys. There you go. If you want to take a look at any of these guns, go to AmericanAirGunner.com. More information there. That's it. We'll see you guys later. I knew you'd have an answer.
Oh, yeah.
You always have an answer.
Always have an answer.
After the break, we'll talk about how it works. A more in-depth look at the technology and the physics that go into making the air bolt one of the most powerful air-powered projectiles on the market. American Airgunner is brought to you by Walther, built for life, and by Air Venturi, the power of air.